My name is Felix. I'm co-founder of Disperse. Disperse is a construction technology startup that is focusing on helping companies manage their projects more efficiently by utilizing computer vision to track all progress on site. However, we actually didn't start within construction. We didn't have any specific industry focus. We did what everybody always tells you not to do, and we started with technology first, having a solution and then finding the problem towards it. So at the very start of our existence, we didn't have any specific focus, and we tried to find it. And I thought the best way I can contribute to this conference is that I can kind of guide you through the journey we had and explain why we ended up in construction and why we feel that it makes a lot of sense for us, but also what was the logic behind it and what is the reasoning that brought us to be focused on the construction industry. So as I said at the beginning, there wasn't a very specific focus for us. We were excited about the idea to help companies that manage larger scale physical infrastructure through machine learning. So collecting a lot of data on physical infrastructure, using machine learning to help the people who manage it to just do it more efficiently, just distill the elements which are interesting for them, and therefore giving them more control over everything. So in the beginning, we didn't at all consider construction. We were talking to retail, train stations, airports, all kinds of different retail, infrastructure operations. And we absolutely had no intention whatsoever to go into construction. Having had a lot of discussions with different stakeholders within those industries, we decided that it's not better for us to focus on a specific industry, rather on a specific problem. So the problem that we identified at that point in time was that infrastructure, which is super overcrowded, is super hard to manage. So at that point in time, we actually started to work with transport hubs. We had a lot of interest from airports, etc., and we would help them just get a better control over their infrastructure. And we ran a couple of really successful trials, but we quickly realized that while there was a clear pain point that we are solving, there was no real path for us to getting revenue anytime soon. The problem is everybody who is running overcrowded infrastructure are very large companies, mainly publicly held, very difficult processes to get in there. So we realized while the problem is an exciting one, the kind of path to revenue is just a near impossible one. So at that point, we reflected again, and thankfully in that moment, we got an invitation to join the Dubai Futures Accelerator, which was kind of the perfect opportunity for us to explore again what we should better focus our technology stack on, especially as by that time we had already built a lot of it. So we wanted to apply it in an intelligent way. And so finally, going into the Dubai Futures Accelerator, in the beginning, we were first ignored by all stakeholders. The accelerator itself is not really an accelerator, it is a mix and match of government entities of Dubai and startups that want to help them change things as they go. So as I said at the beginning, we were pretty much ignored by them. Then we realized how Dubai works, and we designed a really awkward looking device which got the attention of everyone, and it didn't get us just one, but it got us actually two contracts, one with the building department of Dubai and one with the horticulture department of Dubai, which was managing all of the greenery and is producing 1 million plants a year. So this left us in a completely weird state where we actually had two contracts in two different markets. We had also existing relationships and work with train station airports, and we realized that this is not a place for us to be. This is not a place for any startup to be. You need to have a specific focus. You need to know who your customer is and what is the problem that you're solving, essentially. So going through essentially the same reflective process again, this time, us being a bit better is asking better questions and to identify what we should really focus our attention on. We went through that process in a quite analytical way and talked to dozens and dozens of different stakeholders in the different industries. And what came out of it is that construction was overwhelmingly the right decision for us from all kind of different angles. As no matter how we saw it, it was clear that construction is the best place for us to be in. And this is kind of what my main point is. What are these couple of things that made us decide to focus on construction? So the first one is scale. And by scale, I don't mean, yes, it is a very big industry, but that's not really the point. What I mean by that is you have so many different types of projects. You have very small projects, very large projects. You have all kinds of different types of projects. And starting to kind of try to get into an industry, it's incredibly useful when you have all kinds of different arrangements of sizes, different stakeholders, et cetera, et cetera, because you can find your way in one way or another through that arrangement. It also just helps that, given that there are that many different players, you can also you just have enough projects to find enough early adopters, people who actually want to interact with you at an early stage, because that's critical as a startup. And that was quite tricky for us with all the other use cases that we were looking at. Another one is standardization, and many people would say that construction is, from a data infrastructure perspective, super siloed. There is, you know, like there's so many different systems, so many different data types, etc., etc. However, actually, it is manageable, and most importantly, it's actually all in one way or another open. Many of the other use cases that we before explored, there were like clear fences around, and there was absolutely no way for us to get into the existing systems. Construction, just inherently based on how the industry is shaped and how there's many different stakeholders that always work in different constellations with each other, it could never operate in that kind of fashion. You always had data files that in some way or another were transferable. And that actually makes it possible for us and for other companies to interface with them, even if it's not kind of the nice process, but it's possible. And BIM, of course, is also a pretty big point as to why the construction industry is an interesting one. And by that I don't mean like BIM and the logic behind it, but more the enforcement of BIM by the government, which led to all of the main contractors and developers and all kinds of stakeholders to just ask questions about how should we go forward, right? So that changed the industry from being one which is super conservative and where all of the processes have been defined for many, many decades and are stable, are bad, but stable in the way that they are, to an industry which is kind of thinking and reflecting as onto how should we proceed, given that we know that this is sooner or later going to hit us in one form or another. And that leaves an interesting window of opportunity for all kinds of startups. Just the fact that companies started to reflect on we are changing our workflow is just changing the way you interact with them. And I mean, I've grown up in the construction industry, and I never thought that once we hit the market, how much positive feedback we had, how many open discussions we had, and how everybody is actually pretty keen on doing something. 10 years ago, that was certainly not my impression of the industry. And another one is competition, and that was something that really excited us. And it is, as we say, there isn't much going on right now. There aren't many startups. There's not much invested. For a startup being in this space, it is actually really exciting because it means you are not the third debit cards mobile app provider or anything like that, right? You actually have the space as a startup to just develop something, and you are pioneering something with really not many people doing close to anything else like you, right? And that's for somebody who wants to change the way that something's been done is an incredibly interesting point, right? Because it does give you the feeling that you actually can accomplish something, and it brings me to the most important point, and that's the impact sense. And that's exactly the factor of, you know, what is it that you accomplish by changing an industry, right? Us having had a lot of discussions with airports and, well, having been close to pivot towards airport technology, what we saw there is an industry which is actually doing pretty well already. Like, their processes are fairly well defined. Their processes are also so fairly well defined that there was an easy way in for us. But if we would get in, we would be able to make a marginal difference as to how well they are doing. But as we all discussed today, construction is a pretty bad place as it stands right now. And that just creates so much opportunity space, and it gives you also the feeling entering the industry that you if you succeed, can have an incredibly big impact as to how things are done, how people work, how people live, et cetera, right? And that was ultimately for us the biggest reason as to why we decided to fully focus on construction. And it is also the reason why we dropped everything else and about a year ago completely focused on construction. And there's literally not a second where we regret it or where any of the signals, be it from the markets or from the way that our development works, or to some extent even not even from investors so much, where we have the feeling that it was a wrong decision. So far, everything points towards that it is the right place to be in, and it's an incredibly interesting space to be in for any startup. Thank you.